Welcome back to my channel. Oh my gosh, it's been a hot minute since I filmed a YouTube video. It's just been a crazy month. September just like flew by. If you guys know me, I don't ever go anywhere. Like, I'm always in Fargo, I'm always in North Dakota. And then September, I had a friend who got married and she decided to have her bachelorette party the same month. So I was in Nashville, then I was in Arizona. So that was two trips this month. And I have a trip coming up to New York City. I'm going to Gen Live. I think that's what it's called. It used to be called Ipsy Live, I think, but now it's called Gen Live, or it's one of the two. I don't know. I'm going to like a YouTube convention and I'm super excited because I'm gonna meet Angelica there and a bunch of other creators. So if you guys are planning on going, let me know down in the comments. If you see me, come say hi. I don't know if I look the same as on camera as I do in person. I don't know. But I'm so excited because I know at least one of my subscribers I'm gonna get to meet in New York. So very, very excited for all of that. Other thing I want to quickly say is this is like my all-time favorite nude. This is True Story by Morphe. Every time I wear this shade, people ask me what nude I'm wearing. So I just want to put it out there. I want to do a favorites video, just kind of like the ride or die tag that was weirdly popular a few, was it last year? I kind of want to just do that because favorites give me anxiety, like monthly favorites, because I'm like, I don't know, maybe this is just a favorite for like a week. I don't know. Anyway, so I kind of want to do a ride or die favorites, but this is literally like my favorite nude. I was wearing this on my Instagram stories and I got like probably like two or three DMs, which is a lot for me, okay? I have a pretty small like Instagram and YouTube, so I was pretty impressed that that many people were curious about my lip color, so I just want to tell you guys that. The last disclaimer is I'm filming this after work, so you know, if my makeup looks a little sketchy, that's okay. I used to film all the time after work when I used to do my swatch parties. I feel like I haven't done one in forever, mostly because, you know, back in the day it was like a little bit easier for me to get a new launch like pretty fast, but now it's just like impossible. Most things are released in store, so people just pick them up in store, and I don't live in a big city, so I don't really get to do that. I haven't picked up the last few Juvia's Place launches. Those usually come out pretty quick and come get to me in the mail pretty quick, but yeah, I haven't really gotten anything. And I did get my Kaleidos palettes in the mail, and I wanted to be able to like dedicate a video to them, and I wanted to unbox them on camera and stuff. So even though I've had that package for about a month, I still haven't broken into it because, like I said, I've been super busy. So I have a few weekends before New York, so I'm hoping to get that filmed. But today, the reason we're all here, I'm sorry I kept you guys waiting on bated breath for me to start talking about. We're gonna do my Will I Buy It video, and you guys know I do this every other week, so welcome. Okay, so there's like an explosion of holiday palettes and holiday stuff. I already saw that the Too Faced holiday stuff is on sale. Like the Gingerbread Spice palette is on sale. Their Gingerbread Man bronzer is on sale, which I was kind of like eyeing. But then I was like, Karen, you don't need it. There's so much makeup happening, like so many makeup sales. And I just got paid today and I'm already like, no, don't take my money, because I saw so many new things. And then Linda Hallberry is on sale on Beauty Bay, and I've always wanted to try one of her Fantastics and her Infinity palette, the deeper shade, and I'm like, no, 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 no. Like, there's been so many good makeup sales, and I'm trying so hard, you guys. So anyways, so oh my gosh, I didn't realize this was available. So the new Menagerie Cosmetics palette is available now. It's the Killer Purr palette. I low-key want this because the packaging is so adorable, and I told you guys so many times how much my husband loves The Lion King, and this is just totally giving me Lion King vibes, but I don't really need it. I love all the mustard, like the variety of mustards she's included in that palette. Also really have my eye on that green call. Is it Baobab? B-A-O-B-O-B, I think. That green is like what I'm living for right now. There's a green like that in the Natasha Denona Metropolis palette. I'm like obsessed with it. And of course I love that green shade in the Corner Call Waterhole. Overall, I think I talked about this before the palette was revealed, like the shades were revealed, and I said it definitely reminded me of my husband and South Africa and all that good stuff. It's $32 for 12 shades, 10 mattes, and 2 metallics. I still need to film a video with the Whale Song palette. Like, I bought that, and I still haven't shown you guys the palette on my channel, so I really don't need to buy another palette from them. I do really, really want their purple palette, but again, I just don't really need it. So even though there's a lot of really great shades in this palette, it's not something I need, so I'm trying really hard to save, and so I won't be buying that, but I can't wait to see. I'm sure Annette's Makeup Corner probably picked it up, so I'm sure she'll have a video, and I'm excited to see that video. And was kind of an interesting launch. I mean, I'm not surprised that this brand collabed, but it was Kylie and Balmain, and I mean the Kylie and Kendall and you know, all the Kardashians wear a ton of Balmain. I'm pretty sure they're all like friends with Olivier. I don't know how to say his name. Anyway, the lead designer of Balmain is who she collabed with for this, and I mean it's a pastel-esque palette. It reminds me of like the Nomad Harajuku palette a little bit, like the shimmery pastel colors. I haven't bought anything from Kylie in a long time, and this is not really my vibes. I really can't imagine me trying to put an eye look together with this palette. I think the promo images are beautiful, and it definitely, like, the theme, the promo shoot, whatever they're doing, and the palette really go well together, like all those shades. But this is celebrating Paris Fashion Week, and it's all a really cool idea. I just don't think it's like anything I would personally use, so I'm passing on that. The next thing I see on here is something I'm kind of tempted by. This is the new Hourglass Holiday Collection. So it's now available on Sephora and Beautylish. And I'm really, really tempted by actually the 4-Pan Blush Palette. Because I've heard nothing but good things about Hourglass's blush formula. I have 2 of their limited edition holiday palettes from previous years, and I think I have one from as far back as maybe like 2015 or 16, and I finally decided to declutter that one because I hadn't hit pan. I was trying and trying and trying, and I wasn't getting really anywhere with it, and I felt like the product was getting a little old, so I decided to part ways with that one, but I still have one. I think it's from 2016 or 17, that's like in really good condition. So I kept that one because I do love the powders by Hourglass, but I know I'm not gonna need another 6-pan palette like that. But I'm really curious about the blushes. But then I like look at this and I feel like I can wear the top shade, the pink shade, and then the 2 bottom shades, but I'm not sure about that brownie nude color on the top right hand side. So I'm kind of like on the fence about it. Plus it's like a $60 palette, so I'm really on the fence about it. But it's gorgeous, and if you always wanted to try Hourglass, I know people always say like for the ounces and the pounds and whatever, it's not really worth it. But I still think it's a beautiful palette, and I think it would be a fun way to try the brand. They're also launching some like glitter shadows in a pot and some of their lipsticks. I'm not really interested in any of that stuff, so I'm just passing on the whole thing for right now. Here's something I'm so excited about. P. Louise is now being carried at Morphe or Morphe.com, and I really want to try the P. Louise base. I heard Julia Mazzucato mention that the Makeup Revolution Cut Crease Canvas, I think it's called, it's the eye primer I use in most of my videos. She said that that's a really great dupe for P. Louise, but I kind of want to try the original. So I'm glad that you can buy it on US side now instead of like ordering it from the UK. But I would love to hear from you guys. I know a few of you had mentioned that the P. Louise base isn't that great, like it's okay. And there's like a few differences between like the Makeup Revolution formula and the P. Louise formula. But I would love to hear from you guys more if you've tried it. I would like to hear from more of you what your thoughts are, what your impressions are. I added the white shade and like a color close to my skin tone to my cart on Morphe, And with shipping and everything, it was almost $40 for two eyeshadow bases. And like I said, I'm trying really hard not to spend money right now, at least until I get back from New York, just so I know I can cover all my expenses there. So I would be really curious to know what you guys think of the P. Louise base. So Charlotte Tilbury came out with her new Pillow Talk collection. So this is a limited edition holiday collection, and she already came out with a Pillow Talk quad, but this is the Pillow Talk palette of pops. So it seems like all the shades in this palette are shimmers. I really like my Pillow Talk quad. I just don't like it on me. It looks gorgeous on my friends with lighter skin tones. It's a very beautiful quad. So that's the one thing about Charlotte Tilbury. I love her eyeshadow formula, but a lot of her eyeshadow quads seem to be built for people with lighter skin tones. So I wish she would come out with more options and variety in her line. But yeah, I'm not planning on buying this quad. It's $53 for three eyeshadows. And then she came out with a gloss called Pillow Talk for $22. So passing on all of that. Then the next big launch this month, or closing out September, has been Anastasia Beverly Hills. So they came out with a huge collection called the Norvina Collection, and they had three palettes at launch. Two of them launched yesterday, volume 2 and 3, and then they also launched a huge glitter collection. So they're $15 each, and looks like there's about 10 glitters. I personally had a really tiny glitter phase where I would use, you know, pot glitter. I had a few from MAC. Over the years, I'd collected some of their holiday sets and I enjoyed it, but it was a very short-lived phase. It was very high maintenance to put glitter on my eyes, and so I've kind of moved on from that. So I know people do really beautiful looks with glitter, but it's just so not my thing, and therefore I won't be picking those up. Then there is a new launch from ColourPop. They came out with a new line called Pretty Fresh. Now, I don't know if it's a new brand or just a new line. So under ColourPop, maybe they have like the Pretty Fresh line. I honestly have been so busy, I haven't even had time to go on their website and look at this collection. But they basically came out with like more stuff that's geared for hydration. So they came out with a hyaluronic acid tinted moisturizer for $14. They came out with a hyaluronic acid setting mist, a hyaluronic acid primer, a beauty sponge, and then you can get the whole kit for $25. So really great price point. Honestly, just from the swatches, the foundation looks very, very sheer. Doesn't really look like my kind of product, so I'm not really interested in buying it or trying it. I'm so good on the foundation train right now because I bought so many foundations in August, and I'm all set for foundations. I don't need any more. If I buy one, it's gonna really have to intrigue me. The next surprise launch from yesterday was new Pat McGrath holiday stuff. So she launched 4 lipsticks, which I think Kat told me the lipsticks are all repeat shades or re-promotes. These 2 new quads though are so cute. Everyone on my community page kind of was like really blown away by the price point because they are pricey. They're $65 a quad, which times 2 is $125. So basically you could have bought like one of her mothership palettes. So that's a little insane. I didn't really want to spend $65, and I definitely didn't want both. So I compromised and just bought the one I was really interested in, which was the one that was geared more blue tones. So I'm really excited because I saw the Fancy Face. She had gone in store and she swatched both quads. So if you want to see swatches, go on her Instagram and you'll be able to see swatches on her skin tone. The blue one looked very interesting. One of those shades actually looked more green. It was just really cool because I've never seen a green shadow like that from Pat McGrath. She does have a few green shadows in her eyeshadow palettes, but I haven't seen such a light green, so I'm very excited to see that when it comes. I think mine will get here probably Monday. I was hoping it would get here today, but I don't think it's gonna get here in time, so I will try and get a video up as soon as possible when that arrives. And then here is the rest of the Norvina collection. So volume 2 and volume 3 launched yesterday, and they each have 25 shades for $60 each. And honestly, I was so conflicted about this whole situation. I have the volume 1 palette. I haven't even really talked to you guys about it yet. I showed it in my August haul video, and yeah, I just haven't had time to film with it. I used it one time and I thought the neons were really vibrant. And then the next time I sat down to use it, I just looked at it and I was like, oh my god, there's so many purple eyeshadows in this palette. It might be a little too much purple for me. I've just felt like there's been so many purple releases. It's been a little bit overwhelming. So yeah, I was kind of like a little bit like stumped. But then they launched the volume 2. They did sneak peeks and it was so beautiful and blue green. I thought like, wow. But I'm just not sure. I really want to see them in person. So spoiler, I did order them because I thought, you know, since I have a YouTube channel, this would be kind of an interesting palette to just showcase, compare all three, maybe do some swatches. I also kind of want to swatch them based on like colors. So I kind of want to swatch all the purples together and see like what the like shades are. I think that will be kind of an interesting video. So let me know if you guys are interested in seeing that. I just don't get it. I know I've had a lot of discussion with people on my community page about, you know, what Anastasia's strategy is moving forward. Why all of a sudden have they gone from a brand that did like maybe 2-3, you know, big launches in a year to, you know, rapid fire releases. Jackie Ina's palette, then all of a sudden we had the Norvina palette that totally caught everyone off guard, and then two huge palettes right before holiday, and the price bump. From the speculation I heard, people were saying maybe they were trying to recoup investments or try to, you know, pay back their investors. I don't know really how investing works necessarily. I don't know that investors need to see such quick return. I can definitely see Sephora pushing brands to launch more things more frequently, because that generally just seems like the pattern with Sephora. And I believe these palettes are Sephora exclusives, the two, volume 2 and 3. Volume 1 I saw on Ulta's website, so I'm like thoroughly confused about the whole thing. I think it's a whole conspiracy in the beauty community, and so it'll be really interesting if someday all that information comes out. I don't know if they're helping their brand or hurting their brand by launching more things so quickly. I feel like if you invested in something like a makeup company, you would understand that you don't want to like overwhelm your consumers either. So it's like a whole thing. I don't know. Let me know your thoughts though, because I'm very curious about it. I do have a business degree, so I feel like the investor theory kind of makes sense, but I also feel like it's just like there's so many layers to the beauty community that I don't want to speculate either. I would just really like to know, you know, from ABH, what's actually going on. Okay, so Huda came out with her Power Bullets. This is a throwback collection and beautiful retro shades to give you that 90s vibe. I always thought these were beautiful, but the shades never really caught my attention. I don't need to buy any more lipstick. I need to do a lipstick declutter. It honestly like sickens and pains me how much lipstick I have that I don't use. So I want to declutter it. I just have too much and I don't get to spend much time with the stuff I have. So I will definitely be doing some sort of declutter, and all my friends are going to be so happy because they're all going to get lipsticks from me. So other than that, I'm just really not interested in buying bullet lipsticks, and I'm going to be passing on that. Okay, so here's a kind of controversial palette. I don't know, people have been getting a little sensitive about Kat Von D, and I totally get why. I don't really have anything good to say about this palette. So she came out with a Lolita Provida, which is a really interesting name. I don't speak Spanish, so I don't know if that actually means something. If you guys do, definitely let me know. I'm assuming Por Vida is Spanish. I could be wrong. I'm sorry. Anyway, there's 18 shades, matte, shimmery, and metallic finishes for $49.50. I mean, it looks like a really nice neutral palette. I have this palette like 100 times over in my makeup collection, so personally I don't see the need to buy it, but whatever, I don't know, I just thought I'd talk about it. Here's like another controversy that's brewing, Jeffree Star x Shane Dawson collab. I don't know when that's coming out. Oh, it looks like holiday? That'll be interesting. We'll have to wait and see. Okay, so Juvia's Place is teasing another palette. The new Wahala, which means drama, eyeshadow palette, coming out soon. Doesn't say, I think they said November perhaps. This looks really cool. I would love to pick this, well, depending on what it looks like, and the Nomad palette up. I really want the Nomad palette, and they're doing a fall sale right now. I think everything on their website is like 25% off, but not the Nomad palette or the Warrior 3 that they came out with. So I'm like, well, I'm not going to buy anything if the only palette I want isn't on sale. So I'm going to wait it out. But Angelica's really making me want Warrior 3, which I resent, but I'm not going to do it. She had a three looks, one palette video out on it, and like her first look was really, really pretty. But I'm not gonna do it. I'm not gonna do it. I refuse. It looks so pretty though. Like, they have a picture of a deep, deep, deep skin tone wearing the palette on their website, and it's stunning. If I feel not too lazy, I'll insert the picture so you guys can see what I'm talking about. But I'm really curious about this Wahala palette. I wonder what it'll be like. I hope it's not, I don't know. I feel like, I hope that it's like some kind of monochromatic palette. It would be interesting if they do something like that Lime Crime black and like the cool tone palette. That would be really interesting. That packaging I think would really lean to something like that, but we'll see. I don't know. I'm just speculating at this time. So yeah, if you guys have any theories on what it might be, I'd be happy to entertain those down in the comment section. Lime Crime came out with their holiday collection. Looks like they did like a bunch of quads, some lip sets, a bunch of stuff. I haven't bought anything from Lime Crime in a hot second. Those quads are really cute. That green one is kind of catching my attention, mostly because it's green. But other than that, I am not planning on picking that up. Dragon Beauty is coming out with a face palette. This thing has like very interesting packaging. The inside honestly looks pretty meh. Very typical of a contour face palette. I think if you're a huge Dragon Beauty fan, I can see you picking that up, like rushing to go get it. Personally, I'm not interested, so I won't be picking that up. So House Labs finally launched. This is Lady Gaga's makeup line. I know some of my YouTube friends picked up some of the stuff. I've honestly had no interest in this line, so I haven't even really watched any videos on it. I personally just don't care at all. So yeah, I have no opinion on that. Okay, so Fenty Beauty did launch some new products. They did a Diamond Balm number 2 all over veil in Holo At Me, which looks beautiful, and then a liquid Diamond Balm. Both those products look really fun. I'm not really into colorful highlighters, so I did not pick any of that stuff up. NARS is coming out with a huge holiday collection. I think some of this stuff is out. I honestly can't keep up with it. It looks really cool. I think I saw that palette on Sephora as well. There's like an eyeshadow palette. The swatches look horrendous. I'll try and remember to insert those. I just have so many like NARS things from previous years that I haven't even like made a dent in, so I won't be picking up any more of that stuff. Mally Beauty is collabing with RuPaul. And honestly, I'm not even a RuPaul's Drag Race fan, but when I saw this palette, I was really disappointed. It looks like every other palette. I've never really bought anything from Mally Beauty, so maybe they're trying to be like edgy by collabing with somebody like RuPaul. I don't really know anything about the brand, but they've never really struck me as like, not, what's the word, like rebellious or like a renegade vibe, which is the vibe I get from RuPaul, that he's kind of like a pioneer almost in his community. So I don't know, I feel like Mally is kind of an interesting brand, like kind of flies under the radar, so it doesn't seem like the most organic collab, if that's the right word. Who's surprised they launched another monochromatic palette? So I think what they had hinted is they're gonna do a pastel monochromatic collection, so I'm assuming now that they did the purple, they did the peach, I'm gonna assume they're gonna do a pastel blue, a pastel green, which would be really cool. I think it would have been really cool if they just did a 9-pan pastel palette and did like the rainbow in pastel and then also just like a regular saturated rainbow, like a rainbow palette. That would have been really cool. Maybe they'll still do that too. Maybe they'll do a whole series of pastels and then do more pastels. I don't really know. I did finally cave and I bought the So Jaded palette, but I'm also like a little bit pissed off at myself because as soon as I saw it in person, I realized that the shades are not as vibrant as they look in the promo photos, and I'm a little bit mad at myself for falling for it, but it's okay, lesson learned. It's like, I've never bought something and instantly regretted purchasing it as much as I did that palette this year. So I'm still gonna probably do a video of some kind, you know, at least doing like one eye look and swatching it. But I just didn't, like, I used it on my eyes once and I was not blown away by it. So that was a little disappointing. Stila launched a holiday collection. This one is on Ulta Beauty. And they did, you know, some glittering glows, they did some lipsticks, and then they did this palette, which I swear looks like that other bigger palette they have, but paired down with like all the best shades. It's kind of giving me like Auntie Pat vibes, but I've never really been crazy about Stila. I did pick up one of these big palettes because I was curious. I did not like the formula. It was very like dry and crumbly, the shadows were, so I immediately like said back to the mothership and sent it back. BH Cosmetics launched some brow duos. These ones honestly look exactly like the ABH brow duos, so I might pick some of these up. These could be really handy. I think it would be super handy for a makeup artist kit so you don't spend like the ABH price, because what was this, like $9 a pop? That's really affordable. I like to use ABH's brow powder in my brows. That's what I use to fill in any sparse areas, so it would be nice to find an affordable dupe, although it takes me forever to get through a brow powder, so it's not like it's something I'm super worried about constantly having to replace in my collection. Okay, so Dose of Colors is launching, did launch a new concealer. This is the, I don't know, what is this called? Meet Your Hue, a multitasking full coverage concealer available in 30 shades, $24, and yeah, it launched September 19th. Again, concealer and foundation I have so much of. I need to declutter, I need to pare it down, and I still don't need to buy anything. So I know a lot of people have tried out the Dose of Colors foundation, people that I follow, but since there were so many foundation launches, it definitely got prioritized pretty low on my list of things to try out. Plus, I don't think I could buy it in store, and I wasn't gonna wing the color match, so I passed on it. Here is a collection I was really, really excited about. The little Natasha Denona mini gold eyeshadow palette and the highlighter. So I had a 15% off coupon from Sephora and I was like, oh, perfect. Let me just buy that collection. I really, 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 really like the eyeshadow palette. Mainly the two, the gold shimmer and that greenish shimmer. And then the matte olive green is beautiful. I haven't really found too much use for the other two shades. I want to do a video though with that little palette, show it to you guys. I did try the Glow Shimmer Duo and I didn't like it. It was mostly glitter. It didn't really feel like a highlighter. If you like gold sparkles, you might really like it, but I tried it like two or three times and I didn't like it, so I just decided to send it back. I didn't want to keep holding on to it. I hope you guys understand where I'm coming from, but I would not recommend picking that duo up, but the eyeshadow palette is fabulous. Now I really, really want the mini nude palette because everyone raves about how good that is. Okay, so that's it for all the mainstream makeup launches, but I wanted to highlight just a few indie ones that caught my attention. So the first one was, of course, that Killer Purr palette from Menagerie, which I kind of talked about at the beginning because Trendmood did give them a repost, which is amazing. Then the other thing I wanted to talk about is the Midas Coffee Collection palettes. These are gorgeous. My friend Amy Loves Makeup has a code with them. It's Amy Loves and you get to save some money. Personally, the green tone one is really catching my eye. but I think these were like $12 a piece, and I just don't want to part with $12 for a quad. And I already have a lot of these shades. It's definitely giving me like the Staples palette vibe from Give Me Glow. So I'm passing on that, but if that was something you guys were interested in, I just wanted to highlight that for you. And then the other palette that is so gorgeous is from the brand Strobe Cosmetics. I guess they decided to rebrand and now they're called Shroud Cosmetics, which is making me wonder like what rock I was laying under, because I had no idea they changed their name. And then I was like, what the hell is Shroud Cosmetics? But that's neither here nor there. So they just came out with the Arcana palette and it is gorgeous. It's a grungy rainbow, just like Hannah Louise Poston loves, and it's beautiful. I love the greens, I love the shimmers, I love the mattes. It's gonna be gorgeous. It is available for pre-order now. I am not gonna buy it because I already have two of their palettes and their last fall palette. I don't even think I filmed a video about it, so I don't really have the right to buy more palettes from them. And I just, yeah, I'm not gonna do it anymore. I'm not gonna keep buying shit when I have so many palettes to play with, even though I literally have four palettes on its way to me. So yeah, I don't need it. It's gorgeous though. I'm admiring it from a distance. Oh, so many beautiful shades. I will post a picture of these swatches so you guys can see it as well. And then the last little palette I want to give a shout out to is the new Sahara palette. This is from Alter Ego. This is a brand that kind of got famous making dupes. And I have a video where I use their Goddess palette, which is actually right here. This is their dupe to the Natasha Denona Gold palette. Here it is. I really thought this was a good dupe. And they sent me this one. This is their new palette. This is definitely, I think this is a dupe for the Soft Glam palette. Obviously the layout is a lot different from the Soft Glam, so you know, take it for what you will. The packaging is really nice. And how much does this sell for? Sorry guys, hold on, let me check. I don't want to run to their website, but I'm sure it's under 20 bucks. And I have a small code if you want to save some money. I believe it's Karen10, and it's going to be down in the description box. I think I also have a link for the palette. So I haven't played with it yet. I literally got it the day I was leaving to Arizona for my friend's wedding, and it's gorgeous. I mean, like this shade, it's beautiful. I'm so happy they sent this to me. I feel like it's going to be good quality. And look, it's the same size as the Goddess palette. And the packaging's so beautiful. It is. So I know not everyone loves dupes and stuff, and I've kind of given all my disclaimers in previous videos. But if you're interested, I will definitely film a video with that palette, just to kind of see how it works and give you guys my thoughts on it. But that is everything for this Will I Buy It video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments what new makeup launch you are excited for, or if there's something you're not excited for, let me know as well, because I love talking to you guys, and I will see you in my next video soon. Bye!